Hi, I'm Brooke Bland. I'm the STEAM coordinator at Girl Scouts Diamonds of Arkansas, Oklahoma, and Texas. That means that I do STEAM programming and events for my council. STEAM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, Art, and Math. Girl Scouts Diamonds of Arkansas, Oklahoma, and Texas is located here. We are predominantly in Arkansas, and we have a little bit of Oklahoma and a little bit of Texas. Today we are going to be doing one of the activities from the Junior Think Like a Programmer journal. At the end of this video, you will know what an algorithm is. You'll create an algorithm to teach someone else something you know a lot about, and brainstorm how you could use technology to make it easier or more fun. Now let's get started. The activity will take about 30 minutes to complete, with about 5 minutes of prep and 5 minutes of cleanup. You will need a blank piece of paper, some markers, crayons, or colored pencils, and a large poster or several sheets of chart paper. So first, we're going to be learning about algorithms, and then we're going to dig into prototyping and innovations. Let's get started by exploring how computers help us solve problems all day and all over the world. For example, they help us communicate with friends and family more easily. They make it faster and easier to do jobs like delivering mail, manufacturing, farming, and clothing. But computers can't actually think for themselves. They can only do the things that they're told to do. So computer scientists use a special language called code to tell computers what to do. They write a list of steps in code that the computer then follows. That list of steps is called an algorithm. An algorithm is any list of steps to complete a task. You can write or follow an algorithm to complete any task. Now, can you think of something that you could teach somebody else to do, say, in about 15 minutes? For example, you probably couldn't teach someone everything they needed to know about playing soccer, but you could probably teach them how to kick the ball into the net, right? So take a minute to think of something that you could teach somebody else based on what you're really good at. Maybe you know how to draw a house, or make a smoothie, do a dance move, or shoot a basket. Please pause this video to complete this task. Once you know what you want to teach others, you can create an algorithm of 3 or more steps. So write a list of steps with each step on a new line. After you write your algorithm, test it by following the steps, or if there's someone else there, ask them to test it out with you. Please pause this video to complete the task at this time. How did you do? Were you able to follow the algorithm? If not, that's okay. This often happens with computer scientists. When they run their code, they might find a problem or see that their code doesn't do what they wanted it to do. And that's when they go back and fix their algorithm, find where the problem is and fix it. In computer science, a problem or error in a code is called a bug. When you find and fix a bug, it's called debugging. If you need to go back and fix your algorithm to allow for it to go from start to finish, please do so at this time and pause the video. Now that you've created an algorithm for how to do something, let's brainstorm how to make the task easier or more fun with technology. When computer scientists make something new or improve something, that's called innovation. Programmers, inventors, and designers from all over are working to build new innovative technology like cars that can drive themselves and robots that will clean your house. For the last part of this activity, you're going to be doing something called rapid prototyping. A prototype is a rough model of your idea or innovation that you can use to test your ideas and then show it to other people. A prototype can be as simple as a drawing, or it can be created with common materials such as cardboard, paper, string, or rubber bands. When you make different prototypes of your ideas, you can see what works and what doesn't work. Now, think of the skill that you just created an algorithm for. How can you use technology to make the task easier or more fun? The task that I chose was how to do laundry. So I created my algorithm, steps 1 through 7, for how to do laundry. Now, we are going to brainstorm how we can make laundry easier. So for me, laundry would be easier if my clothes in the washer went to my dryer. So I drew a washer, and this is the inside of my washer, and there's an arm that pushes the clothes into the dryer. The second type of prototype that I drew was a washer on top of a dryer, where the washer opened up and the clothes fell into the dryer and it would start. So now, create a prototype of your new technology by sketching it on the larger sheet of paper. Remember, this is a rapid prototype. That means that you're going to be working fast. That way you can quickly see what works and what doesn't work. So please pause this video at this time to complete this task. Once you've sketched your prototype, you can share it with others and continue to look for ways to make it even better. Or you might find some supplies like tape, cardboard, or glue and see if you can build another prototype of your idea. Please pause this video at this time if you would like to complete this task. After you do something new, it's a good idea to think of what you learned, what you liked or didn't like, and what is something that you might want to do next. So after the activity, ask questions like, what did you find enjoyable? Did you like thinking of things that you were good at? Did you like writing out an algorithm? Or did you like drawing your prototype or making your prototype? Why did you like those things? What did you find challenging? Was it challenging for you to get your algorithm step by step? How did you deal with that? Were you able to ask for help or problem solve on your own? What did you learn? Did you learn all the different steps that it takes to create an algorithm? Did you learn how to create a prototype? What surprised you? These are important questions to ask yourself after doing an activity like this, so you continue to learn from your experiences. And that's it. You've completed an activity from the Think Like a Programmer journey. You've learned about algorithms and how computers follow them when they solve problems. Just like computer scientists, you brainstormed how you can use technology to invent or improve something to make it easier or more fun. If you like this experience, learn more about how computer scientists solve problems with the Think Like a Programmer journey, or try out the activities in the Cybersecurity and Coding for Good badges. If you or your Girl Scout like this activity, like this video and tell us in the comments below what you enjoyed. And be sure to subscribe to our channel and to get other videos with fun Girl Scouts activities to do at home. See you next time!